smell so fresh. So guys, welcome to the Linux channel. So if you are a network software developer or a system software developer working in networking protocols or networking stack, as well as if you are a network admin, in case if you are doing some sort of investigation and as well as learning the TCP/IP as well as investigating some kind of packet flow while using Wireshark, you have a wonderful feature called as flow graphs in the statistics menu. And using flow graphs, you can do some sort of deeper analysis of packets in terms of TCP session wise, because if you see a Wireshark packet capture, it just captures discrete packets, whereas with flow graphs you can just put all the pieces together and then you can see the entire session. And as well as in case if you are doing say for example, recently I was doing an investigation for my upcoming toffee butterscotch project, so I need to investigate the window scaling options of TCP. So I need to do some amount of analysis in terms of session wide TCP analysis. So using flow graphs, it is quite easy because you are not anymore dealing with discrete packets, because when you deal with discrete packets, you will get to and fro all sorts of packets mixed together. And sometimes if you have multiple TCP sessions, what happens is it just combines everything together. So what we can do is we can just before I do a live capture, I have stored Netgear readiness packet capture, as you can see in my desktop. So this is my Netgear readiness packet capture, which I just took sometime a while ago, because I need to investigate some SMB packets when I'm doing some development in Toffee, as well as optimizing this SMB packets as such, the entire SMB protocol packet. So when doing same, I was just using this feature, the flow graphs, and then I was doing the analysis of the same. So I thought, let me take this as a good example before we do some kind of live packet capture and analyze the same. So what I can do is I can open this in Wireshark. Yeah, as you can see here, just like that, if you open any sort of packet capture, you will get this entire discrete view of packets, and the flow it shows in almost a real-time flow, because it just shows whatever it has received and whatever it has been transferred. And in case if you have any Linux based router and then install Wireshark on top of it, exactly the same thing again happens. You get some kind of to and fro discrete view of packets. So with the discrete view of packets, you can just do analysis of packet wise analysis. You can do per packet analysis, like you can just click any specific packet and you can see various headers, and you can do the regular analysis with Wireshark. But beyond that, you need something like per session wise analysis. You can just use the Wireshark's flow graphs. So for that, what you can do is you can go to the statistics and then you can select flow graph. So as you can see here, it entirely changes, it entirely displays a new window almost as such. As you can see here, this you can move it across, you will still have that old standard Wireshark view. And it's also important that whenever you choose a specific packet in this session, it is going to highlight over here, as you can see in my monitor as such. So whenever I choose a specific packet, as you can notice, it is just highlighting the corresponding packet in that gray bar. So you can notice here. So let's just, for example, I'm clicking this ARP packet. You can see here it is highlighted already, this ARP packet over here. It is quite tricky, although I have a large monitor, it is still tricky to view, but it is nevertheless, it is quite a useful feature as such. So maybe they can just do this window as a sort of dock within the Wireshark. But again, as you can understand, Wireshark interface is quite detailed. No matter how large is the monitor, it is quite detailed, and you wish you get the entire big picture of what is happening inside the network flow. So when you do this, you can just have a look like this. But whenever you are doing some deeper analysis, still as you can see here, it has not put any pieces together, because it is just showing as it is everything mixed together. You can see here there is a TCP packet, and below this you have this NBSS, and then it is just, things are, you know, still looking as if it is messed. So what you can do is you can select this option called as flow type as, you know, TCP flows. So with this you can almost do analysis of per session TCP packet flow. So this is now filtered, and it is just showing a session wise packet flow. As you can see here, it has sent a SYN, and then it has received an ACK, and you know, followed by which you can see it has sent this push ACK. In this example, what I have done is I just opened a few folders here and there, and then browsed across the folders in my NAS server. I have not done any heavy file download or file upload operation. So this is going to look more like a small discrete set of packets, because if there is any sort of file download operation happens, that is when the sliding window kicks in, and then you can see a bunch of you know, push ACK packets followed by a single ACK, and this set changes based on your network congestion, based on your network speed and things like that. And moreover, since it is my local area network, it is going to happen very fast, and you can't see the real effect as long as you do this sort of analysis in your local area network based traffic. And for this you can do a live capture of your internet traffic. The more slower your internet is, the more interesting it is going to look. The more faster is your internet, more it is going to look more or less like your LAN network. So you can see here it has sent this push ACK, and then followed by push ACK. As you can see here, the window has not fully opened up, so it is just doing a couple of push ACKs for every ACK. And after some time, you can see here there are more multiple push ACKs. It is more receiving, and then followed by, you know, ACK and things like that. So this gives a good picture, and it is also neatly color coding session wise. So you can see earlier it is in green color, followed by which to the port 139, and let us see what is this port corresponds to. So port 139, and then I think the port 139 corresponds to SMB. So I don't much remember the port number of SMB. So once you go down, you can see here the next session is with respect to port 445, and you can see it is highlighting this specific packet on the top. So you can again investigate these packets, and since it is all arranged session wise, you can see here bottom it is all arranged. Okay, if you follow my mouse, you can see here all of them are arranged, but on the top you can see it is just highlighting that corresponding packet in the entire discrete set of packets, or else discrete set of packet flow. So this is the beauty of Wireshark's flow graph, and you can do a lot of analysis in case if you are even an expert level kernel or else a systems network stack developer. You can use this feature and you can investigate what's exactly happening in the network, and in case if you have any bottlenecks, or in case if you are working any sort of networking device, or you are working towards any sort of traffic optimization schemes, and as well as QoS schemes and things like that, you can just intercept a Linux box, and then you can trace what is exactly happening within your network. So next, what I can do is I can do a live packet capture. We can just check a couple of websites, and we can just do a quick analysis. Although I'm shooting this video, I'm still relatively new to Wireshark's flow graphs, because I have not much used this feature quite often as such. I just used as and when once in a while as such, whenever there is a need, but I'm not much explored all its features, and I feel somewhat somewhere it is not that interactive in the sense, like when you click this or when you click this, it must have showed even more additional packet details or something like that, or perhaps I may not be aware of a specific feature as such. But nevertheless, I'm quite happy in terms of whatever I know, and I'm quite happy because I was looking for a few answers, and really I got with the flow graphs because unlike the regular Wireshark interface, you can't get a clue what is exactly happening. And especially even if there is any packet retransmitter, this tool is going to be very useful because it is just going to show even more clearly what exactly is happening in the network. So guys, moving on, what we can do is we can just do a live packet capture. So for that, we need to open Wireshark with sudo access, because this needs a super user permissions to capture the packets. So you can just, let me just open the same. Yeah, so ENO1 is my network interface. I can do a packet capture to the same, and we can open any test website. Let's just take, for example, Toffee website. Let me take two examples. One is port 80, the most simplest as possible. The next is SSL port, or something like YouTube or something we can take as an example. So I just opened this single page in this. We can just do a quick analysis of the same. I'm just browsing multiple sites. So let me just open something else which contains as well some images. So this is my recently new project which I started working, and while doing the investigation of the same, especially I have discovered this flow graphs, which is really useful in terms of doing some investigation of TCP optimization. So what we can do is we can just stop the capture, and as you can see here, it is just showing discrete packets. And one more interesting feature, hope you must have noticed in Wireshark, is it's also going to show a sort of preview, a color-coded bar over here, a sort of a band over here. So let me just move the mouse across. You can notice here, so it is just going to show this bar corresponds to this color-coded packets. So there are certain packets over here. Let me just scroll down. Say for example, this particular packet is in yellow color. It is just represented somewhere here. So this is also an interesting feature. And let us go to the flow graph. You can see here it is just almost mixed up everything. It is also showing a DNS session and followed by DNS session, what exactly happened and things like that. So what we can do is we can just again select TCP flows. So with that, you can see it is connected to a couple of SSL ports. Maybe it is for Google Analytics, as you can see here. Just before that packet, you can see it has got a replay of Google Analytics. So that's what exactly it is doing. And below that, you can also see the basic port 80 access. So let me just see which packet it is. Synac, Pushac, yeah, it is sending the get packet of page equal to documentation to my Toffee website, as you can see here. So this is a regular standard HTTP access, and with respect to standard HTTP access, you can see exactly what is happening, and it is neatly color coded, as you can see here, and it is just showing multiple sessions. So it is quite handy this way. And you can see already, with respect to SSL also what exactly is happening. But more than this website, I just want to give a sample of kernel.org, because kernel.org doesn't have any sort of pollution like this. It's just pure SSL and few things here and there. I can even take YouTube as an example, but maybe for better analysis, I have done a couple of times. Kernel.org is quite handy. It is the most simplest SSL website you can find in the internet. So what we can do is we can just close this, and we can just do a fresh capture. So let me just select kernel.org. Yeah, it's just opened. Let me just stop this packet capture, and then we can go to flow graph. Yeah, with this SSL, you can really clearly see the entire handshakes happening across client and server, and whatever has been exchanged and the sequence of the same. You can even isolate when is your real data exchanges are getting started and when is your handshake, packets are being exchanged. So this is quite really interesting, and it really shows very much in depth, as you can see here. And you can again select TCP flows, and it it is going to change the color coding and it is going to show in-depth analysis. So with respect to that, you can just move this window away and then you can just see its corresponding packets. And there are cases, especially if you have really multi-monitor Linux-based system, you can just move this window altogether to a different monitor and you can just see its corresponding packet, and then you can do a neat analysis of the same. So since what alternatively I can do is, let me just scale this window so that we can see here its corresponding data. And let's say, for example, we can take a basic handshake which is not encrypted. What I'm exactly seeing is the basic initial packet exchanges, say like client hello, server hello, and things like that. As such, I'm not sure why it has been missed. So what I can do is I can just close it down and we can try YouTube, let's say, for example. So this time I don't want to miss anything. Let me start the packet capture, and it is started. So let me close this and let me take YouTube. Yeah, it started YouTube, and it does. Done. We can see here there is a server hello and a client hello, and it is exchanging this certificate information and things like that. I'm not an expert in security based protocol, so what I can do is I can just stop this capture, and again we can do a flow graph. Yeah, with this you can see here how it is representing these initial few set of packets as such. Yeah, as you can see here, it shows these exchanges, packet exchanges. It is highlighting this client hello, server hello, and right after that, it is also sending its set of protocols which are supported, or else set of methods or algorithms it supports, and then followed by which you can see the exact application data which is encrypted. So you can clearly see this will happen with respect to kernel.org as well. I think I have started a capture right after opening the website or something like that. So otherwise this is going to be the same. You can try with your Facebook page, you can try with YouTube, you can try with Gmail or anything as such. It is going to be more or less going to look similar to this as such. So with this we can apply the filter TCP flows, and we can see here corresponding to this, it is highlighting in this case when I click this packet, it is highlighting this client hello, and then followed by which if I click this, it is highlighting this key exchange server hello done, and then and followed by which you can see here as well. So that's all guys, hope you guys liked watching this video. So in case if you are struck with anything happening in your network, if it is something you feel it is malicious, and recently there was been a big DOS attack in US network infrastructure, internet infrastructure, so things like that. In case if you have some issues and some sort of glitch happening in your even a home-based internet, you can use this tool and you can verify what is exactly happening. In case if you are getting also some sort of inbound malicious or suspicious TCP SYN packets, if you are receiving, and some sort of hidden app, especially in case if you are using any smartphones or IoT device, in case if it is communicating with any remote server, you can investigate. And you can also investigate with respect to the entire sessions, not just capturing few discrete packets with Wireshark, and try to understand what is happening in the network. So hope you guys liked watching this video guys. So in case if you have any questions, post it in my YouTube comments, or else you can send me an email across. So thank you once again for watching this video guys. Have a nice time. Bye bye.